In the darkest hour, Jesus has a tendency to shine the brightest. Can I hear an amen? Could you say it together? We do not lose heart. And that's in the text here in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16. So in King James it says, "For which cause we faint not." Other translations say, "We don't lose heart." So let's say it together, keep kingdom focus. So stop looking in the rearview mirror of life and start looking out the windshield in the front of the car and keep kingdom focus even in the middle of all kind of mess. Say together, "I'm in a kingdom business. I don't like this. I don't like that. I don't like this." Well, I'm in a kingdom business. I'm going to tell you right now, I love serving Jesus. Here is the apostle giving a testimony about his life. Go ahead and tell somebody, in life, you're going to have some real challenges. You're going to have some real trials. Now, the church is pretty good about that. But when they make it personal, they have a tendency to duck and run. So let's say it together. I will have trials, but the Lord will never leave me. He'll never forsake me. He'll be with me in the middle of it. And I believe at the end of the matter, praise God, that we'll see the blessing of the Lord in it. All right, now, here's some of Paul's deal. Of the Jews, I received 40 stripes minus one. Three times I was beaten with rods. Once I was stoned. Three times suffered shipwreck. A night and a day in the deep, floating in the ocean. In journey often, in perils of water, in perils of robbers, in perils of my own countrymen, in perils by the heathen, in perils in the city, in perils in the wilderness. Are we getting this? How many of you know he took some time under the anointing of the Holy Spirit to say, here's some of the mess in my life. He's not ducking and running. He's not hiding from it. He's not whining about it. He's not complaining. Because how many of you know God was glorified in his life? Miracles came out of it. Revival even came out of it. Whole islands came to know the Lord Jesus. The same man that said, we don't lose heart. We don't grow faint around here. That man had this going on in his life. He didn't walk around like this. I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to hear about it. I don't want to be involved with it. That doesn't have anything to do with me. Yes, it really does. How do you not lose heart? Well, you're consistent, number one. Number two, you persevere. Number three, you obey the Holy Spirit and do what he said. Number four, when he speaks and gives you vision, you cast it. You share it with your family. Number five, gather, gather, gather. Well, I see that if you're a pastor. Well, yeah, what about your cousins and nephews and nieces? Come on. And your uncles and aunts and family and neighbors. Go like this. Gather. Teach the word. Because teaching the word is going to help solve all these problems. Preach the gospel, heal the sick, and cast out devils. Number eight. The problems in the world, the enemy wants them to be worked into the church. So we have a job to do to identify what's going on out here and know what the Bible says and not carry that mess into the house of God, but carry this out into the mess. To be a light in the world, but not be of the world. Praise the Lord. You're not going to lead anybody to Jesus being like them, doing what they're doing. It's sin. You're going to lead people to Jesus by doing what's right and being a light and just loving on them. Now the world is all over is dealing with rebellion. Lord help. Say again, Lord help. And the enemy wants to bring that rebellion into your heart and into your family and then into the church and into your community and into the government. Hello? Only thing that helps us all get on track and by the grace of God stay on track is the Holy Spirit, the Word of God, and being swift to repent. Let's say together, oops. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Verse 16 through 18. For which cause we faint not. We don't lose heart. We don't become doubtful. We don't walk in unbelief. But though our outward man perish, our inward man is renewed day by day. So go like this. In the middle of all the mess, and I may be getting older, might be slowing down a little, might have had some real physical challenge, but my spirit man, say together, my spirit man is being renewed day by day. My spirit man's renewed day by day. For our light affliction. Did you read that list? Our light affliction. The nothing. It's just a distraction. You can see a lot of people out there floating in the water. Can't see land anywhere. Sharks all around the place. Oh, we're going to die. I'm not. This is a light affliction. This doesn't amount to nothing. I got a lot to do after this. Hello? And I have things to do. Grab a hold of that. I have a future. I have a vision. Come on, somebody. I have prophetic words over my life that are not done yet. I'm going to live. We're going to die. No, actually, We're headed for a revival. But first, we got to get a fire so we don't die of hypothermia. And then we got to walk in faith and shake off a snake in the fire. Then we'll have revival after some get healed. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn. They'll be comforted. Blessed are the meek. They get the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness. They shall be what? Filled. Hungry people will be where miracles are. Just come hungry for God and watch what God will do. I'm not trying to correct anybody. I'm just preaching the word and hope we get on fire and grab a hold of God. Can I hear an amen? And I want the word of God to just be inside each one of us and produce life to the glory of God.